Indira Gandhi National Open University. We are trying to provide you some important updates on submission of assignments, project works, dissertations, and examinations. Coming to the assignments part. Already, as you all know, IGNOU has allowed the students of Indira Gandhi National Open University to submit the assignments through online mode. For the June term and examination, those who are willing to write the June term and examination, they can submit the assignments through online mode. And this online mode can be of anything. Let us say, some regional centers, they accept the assignments through email, the regional center email ID, or some regional centers, they are preparing some Google formats to receive the assignments from the students. Likewise, Chakpatnam Regional Center also has developed a Google form for the submission of assignments. So the students can easily go to the link given here and they can submit the assignment. And how to submit the assignment? First, the students are required to download the question paper from the IGNOU website. All the assignments are uploaded on regular basis in the website. For the June term and examination, whatever is available in the IGNOU website, that can be downloaded by the students as per their program concern, and they can start writing the assignment. Assignments can be written on white paper or ruled paper, any kind of paper which is available to you now in this pandemic situation. So you take any paper which is neat and clean and prepare your assignment, and that should be legible for the evaluators, because the evaluator has to easily evaluate the paper. They can easily, they should be able to easily read the paper. So ensure the assignments are neat and clean and legible. And you have to keep a cover page on the assignment. When you write the assignment, remember you have to prepare a cover page with your details like name, enrollment number, program code, course code, etc. And you can also give your mobile number and the email ID also, because if there is any discrepancy in the receipt of the assignments, that can be communicated to you. And you have to scan the assignment after that. After completion of writing the assignment, please scan the assignment using any mobile application or any other application available in the website. And you can scan the assignment in PDF format. The PDF format is the most appropriate format for submitting the assignment, and we are also receiving only PDF format. So prepare the scanned assignment in PDF format and submit it through the Google link which is already explained to you. And however, the last date to submit the assignments is extended up to 15th June 2020. Already you all know that 31st May was the last date, but now that is extended till 15th June 2020. And the students of our regional center, particularly the Visakhapatnam Regional Center students, should submit the assignments through the given Google form link. The other regional center students, whoever is available here or residing in nearby localities, they cannot submit the assignments to us, because the content regional center is responsible for the evaluation of the assignment. They only can update your marks. That's why you please remember, you have to submit the assignments to the concerned regional center only. If you submit it any other place, that will not be evaluated and you will lose the marks. And coming to the projects and dissertations and field works, this is also one of the major components. This is also one of the major components in the internal evaluation of Indira Gandhi National Open University. And you have to submit these components compulsorily for successful completion of the program. So just to facilitate the students, since it is not possible for all the students to come all the way to the regional center or the study center or to post the project report, so university has decided to accept the projects or dissertations or fieldwork journals, whatnot, everything through online mode. So you need to do first prepare the proposal and then get it approved by the concerned supervisor or guide or the study center or at the regional center or at the school of study, because for various projects, we have different kinds of guidelines. So basing on that, you have to submit the project report, submit the project report along with the synopsis, approved synopsis, and your declaration and guide certificate of originality, and all these things, whatever is required for submission of a project report in hard manner, in physical time, the same rules are applicable here also, except the submission will be done through online mode. So you have to get the proposal approved first to submit the project report. And how to get the approval? First, you prepare the proposal as per the norms laid down in the program guide or the project manual. And you strictly follow the project guide and prepare the project proposal or synopsis, whatever it is, and give it to your supervisor. Send the project proposal to the supervisor or the study center or the regional center or the authority, so that that will be approved by the concerned authority and it will come back to you after the approval. So if it is approved, then you can continue happily with the project report. If it is rejected in any case, or if they found any discrepancy in the project synopsis, then you have to redo the thing again. So if you get the approval, you please prepare the project as per the norms, as per the guidelines given in the project guide, and then you make it a PDF format of the project. And as you all know, all the requirements, the first title paper and the declaration by the student as well as the supervisor, and the project approval, pro forma in original, all these things should be there in the PDF format. And then make a single file, and you should submit only one file per project, because we do not accept multiple files for a single project. So you have to prepare one single project report soft copy in PDF format. And how to submit? You should give the first page of the project report in this way, where you find all these details: title of the project report or dissertation, whatever it is, and name of the learner, your name, your program code, whether it is MP, if it is a management program, MP, if it is DNHE, PNHE, like that. You have to mention the program code and your enrollment number, the regional center code, the course code for which you are submitting. If it is management, you have to mention that MS-100 is the project code. So like that, you have to mention the number of the code of the course, and you have to give your mobile number and email ID, because many times if the evaluator finds any difficulty in understanding your project report, or if there is any discrepancy, they can get back to you through your email ID or the mobile number. So if you finish the project report in this order, there would not be any problem. But if there is any discrepancy in these matters, if you fail to submit any of these documents, then the project is liable to rejection. And you have to prepare the scanned copy project or the PDF format project through email to the concerned authority. What is the concerned authority? Generally, in IGNO, for all the programs, we are accepting the projects at the projects section in student evaluation division. So that is the nodal point. But for some of the programs like MA Education, BE, MA, MCA, BCA, for these kind of programs, the regional center concern is the nodal center for the submission of projects as well as for the Viva Voce examination. So you have to follow the guidelines stipulated in the program guide or project guide. So wherever it is applicable, you have to submit the project to them. So if it is student evaluation division, the mail ID is also given in your project guide, or you can also take it from the IGNO website, and you can easily submit the project along with all the requirements as suggested now to the student evaluation division. Projects at the rate of igno.ac.in is the project email ID, and you can submit the projects to that email ID. If it is at the regional center, then you have to submit the